Now for you, a Fox 5 I-Team investigation.
Well, it is campaign season, so there's a good chance you'll see political ads in your mailbox.
But critics tell our I-Team that campaign flyers sent by an independent committee in Republican Senate races may have violated state campaign laws.
Senior I-Team reporter Dale Russell followed the money trail that has many Republican candidates hopping mad. Dale?
Russ, that's right. Republican senators have a plan that sounds like something right out of the CIA, the Incumbent Protection Program. It was simple: raise money for Republican state senators who are running against other Republicans. It's a good deal for the incumbents if how they did it is legal.
You know, some people will say and do anything to get elected.
To win an election these days, you need a lot of money for TV ads, campaign mailings, internet sites, and yard signs. For years, Georgia Republican senators have had their own political action committee. The PAC had a key job: raise money to protect each other. They did pretty well. Their last public filing showed the Republican PAC raised nearly $700,000, money to support Republican Senate incumbents. But there are rules about how much money a PAC can give a candidate. Apparently, some Republican leaders didn't like those rules, so they set up what's known as an independent committee, which doesn't have spending limits. Then, the PAC gave the committee $140,000, which could now spend as much as it wants. But this independent committee is supposed to be, well, independent and not linked to any candidates. But look at this email signed by Republican leadership revealing they picked the man to run the so-called independent committee, gave him a list of senators facing primary opposition, threw in those senators' legislative accomplishments, and then handed over the cash.
How could that possibly be independent under any circumstance?
William Perry, director of government watchdog group Common Cause, believes this money game may violate state campaign laws.
You can't fund it and it be independent. You can't suggest which candidates for it to protect and it remain independent. And you certainly can't provide background information on the candidates for it, for that group to be able to use in mail pieces.
That independent committee spent more than $125,000 on flyers for six hand-picked incumbents, including Senate Majority Leader Chip Rogers, Don Balfour, Jack Murphy, Bill Heath, Cecil Staton, and Frank Ginn, all members of that Incumbent Protection Program.
What the heck is an Incumbent Protection Program?
They're representing their interests. They're trying to keep their positions. This isn't about their party.
I think it's sad. I think this is why the public erodes their trust in government, is because of these type shenanigans.
Brandon Beach is running against one of those Republican incumbents, Chip Rogers. Beach is a DOT board member and believes the Republican leadership violated campaign laws. He says voters should pay close attention.
Voters should care. We want to send people down to the Gold Dome that have ethical backgrounds, that want to do the right thing and serve them for the right reasons.
Now, we couldn't get the Republican Senate leaders to talk to us on camera. On the phone, Senator Bill Cowsert, he's the head of the Republican caucus, told me that they didn't believe that they violated any campaign laws. Russ and Amanda?
Makes you wonder whether it violates the spirit of the law.
You know, this is what will be hashed out now in the future over how this thing is perceived by everyone. I am told and have talked to a number of people, the members of this Republican caucus are not happy about this.
Right.
And it's going to be interesting to see how it plays out.
All right, we know you'll stay on top of it.
We will, and also wanted to say that there were two campaign ethics complaints filed on this, one against Chip Rogers and one against Jack Murphy on this very issue. Those surfaced up in some local political blogs. They've been filed, so interesting to see if they'll be investigated and how that'll go.
All right. Dale, thanks.
Thanks.